Welcome guys. In today's video, we are going to unbox and assemble the Burchda R5 Pro. It's hidden in here. I know I'm gonna be doing a full review on this bike, but before we can do the full review, well, we gotta get her unboxed and put together. So let's get into it. Obviously, you're gonna need something sharp to go ahead and cut these straps. Although these are the kind of straps that you can supposedly pull on and they come undone if you do it in the right spot. I'd rather just chop it up. And there she is. Initially, I don't see any damage, so it looks like everything's packed up pretty well. Let me pull this box out. It's just like, you gotta shake it because you feel like it's Christmas morning and you don't know what's in the box. Now for assembly, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna cut the sides here, leaving like a work floor for this. I'm gonna use this totally rusty box cutter. Looks like she got beat up a little bit in transport, but all of that will come right off. Out of here with that. Fun fact, Styrofoam is my least favorite product in the world. This is everything that comes in the box. I ended up hosing down the tires to get all that styrofoam off there, but you get this headlight, you have the headlight mounting equipment, your pedals, metal fender, here's your charger right here, but it looks like they threw in various like gifts. So you have a bike lock, you have a side mirror, you have a multi-use pump and a phone holder, plus your directions on the bike, the user manual. We want to put the handlebars on, and the first thing you're going to have to do is get this piece, the stem, past this right here. Now, to do that, it's pretty tight. You're going to use a Allen wrench here. You're going to loosen the side here so that it can pull up a little bit. And now we can turn it so that we can assemble the handlebars. Once you do that, you're going to want to tighten this thing up so you can just, so it'll just hold in place without rattling around. And now you want to take these four bolts off because you're going to put your handlebar system right there and go ahead and unscrew it. Now that we have that removed, we're going to bring our handlebar system around now so you know which is the correct side you want your brakes facing out. You will use this pattern right here to help you adjust your handlebar angle. Now that it's up there, you're going to go ahead and put on your bracket. You're going to have to work around these wires. I mean, you always have to anyways. We're going to put that on there, and then we're just going to get these started. Feel free to move the handlebar around so that it gives you the room to just get these in. We're just going to tighten them up, not completely, but enough to where this thing does not move. To ensure your handlebars are set up correctly, it has this little bullseye thing right there. Line it up right in the middle. You want to try to put where the numbers are on both sides. See, that looks really good. And what we're going to do is we're going to do a counter. Well, we're going to do a crisscross pattern. We're going to tighten up one bolt from the bottom. Tighten it up some. And then we're going to tighten the one up here at the top. Bounce back down to the bottom. Tighten it up. And then finish up with the top. This can always be adjusted later, but at least we have the basics of what we need. It's time to put on the front wheel. Now, when I do that, I don't want to mess up this display, so I actually grabbed the protection blocks that were in the box. I'm going to put it on the ground, rest the handlebars on there, therefore protecting the display. Next, grab your 18-inch wrench here, and you're going to loosen these two inside nuts. And pull this piece out. This is a brake block. It keeps the brake pads from squishing together. Since these are hydraulic brakes, if you did that, you would have to pry them apart. That's what this does. It helps protect it from doing that. Pull that out, and now we can put on the front tire. Before putting on the front wheel, we need to loosen these bolts right here, and you're going to have a washer and then this little clamp that will connect into the forks. You have to do it on both sides. Make sure your rotor is on the same side as your brake. We're just gonna slide it in here. You're gonna line up the brake. You're gonna fit it right in that slot. You're gonna have to put the nuts out very far. Like you feel like they're gonna just pop on out. Grab your 15 millimeter wrench and we're gonna go ahead and tighten everything down on your, on the side that has the brake. You're gonna tighten it by bringing it towards the front of the bike. And on the other side, you're gonna tighten it by bringing it towards the back of the bike. Now we can turn the bike back over. We have this kickstand. We'll just pop that out. Grab the bike. And put it back on the front. Right now the handlebar should be misaligned with the front tire. What we're gonna do is we're gonna stand here in the middle and we're just gonna turn it to where we need it, to where it lines up. Then you're gonna grab your Allen wrench and you're gonna tighten these bolts over here on the side of your stem. The top one cranks towards the back seat, as does the bottom one. Now that I have the bike over, it doesn't really want to stand up because the tires are lower than what the kickstand is. So this is a good time to air up your tires. You can use the tire pump that came with the bike. I happen to have a couple different electric pumps, so that's what I'm gonna use. I'm gonna put the tires to 20 pounds PSI. To assemble the fender, what we're gonna do is we're gonna use our 10 inch wrench right here. And you're just gonna put it on the back of this nut. Then you use your Allen wrench, you're gonna loosen it. And what we need to do is we need to remove the nut off the back of this so we can slide our fender mount inside here. You have a nut and a washer. Take your fender, and you're just gonna slide it up into there for the moment. Now go ahead and put your washer and nut back on this back bolt to hold it up there to keep it from sliding off. You need to keep it loose so we can attach the bottom supports to the fork. To connect the side supports to the fender, you're going to loosen up this bolt and nut right here. Go ahead and grab your 10 inch wrench and we're just gonna remove it from the bracket. Then take your fender support, you're gonna put the bolt and the washer on this outside part, grab your nut again, and then we're just gonna gently connect it just so it doesn't come unhooked. And then we're gonna do the same thing to the other sides. Just hand tighten each one of these sides. From here, we're gonna tighten down each side to where it is secure and snug and tight. And then lastly, you're gonna tighten this front part up until it is snug. Now it is time to install the headlight. You're gonna need this bracket here and this one as well. Let me show you how that works. You see where the fork stops? Well, you're gonna put this big bracket right here, but this piece will fold in like that and then creating a link point for you to put a bolt and nut. So we're gonna slide that in there and boom, that's where that goes. We're gonna grab one of our nuts and bolts, which you want these right here, and you're just going to run it from the outside in. You want this part on the outside and the nut. You want the bolt on the outside and the nut on the inside. Just hand tighten it. And then we'll do the same thing to the other side. Now that both sides are just hand tightened because we want those to be able to move, this is your light and it has these two holes on each side and you're gonna be using these hex bolt to connect it through this bracket. The wire to connect it is down here, so it's gonna be facing down and everything else is gonna be facing forward. There is a rubber washer that's gonna go in between the bolt and the light. So you got the bolt here. You're gonna put the washer behind the bracket and then we're just gonna screw it into the light and just make sure it's hand tight. We're gonna do the same thing to the other side. So now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna tighten up all the bolts here in the front. The kit comes with a screwdriver. You just take it and just slide it into the handle. It pops in there, at least it should. Grab your 10-inch wrench and just tighten it up. To tighten up the headlight, we're gonna go ahead and use the 14-millimeter wrench. We're gonna tighten up both sides, just enough to where we can adjust it to how we want. Let's go ahead and connect the headlight to the battery. You have this orange plug right here, and you can see there's a little notch at the top. There's also an arrow at the top of this plastic coating. Then you find the other end here, match up the arrows, and push it into place. Tuck the connector back there, and this part is done. Pedals have a left and right side to them. Now this crank right here shows you this is the right pedal. It even tells you which way to turn the wrench to tighten it. The pedals have an R on one side and an L on the other. Well, we know that this one goes right here. When it comes to pedals, I like to use a little grease. For me, I feel like it keeps it from creaking later on down the road. You don't have to do that if you don't have this, but I do a lot of e-bike. So I got this Park Tool grease. I'm gonna put it on the threads. Once I have the grease on there, I'm gonna put it on all of the threads. Just swing it around. And now we're ready to go. Grab your 16-millimeter wrench. You wanna line it up. Get it on there and just spin it on. I like to take off the little red cap. People don't need to know that this thing let me know it was right and left. I like my bikes looking clean. Now we're just gonna go ahead and do the same thing to the other side. Now don't forget to sit on the bike, get this adjusted exactly how you want it, and then tighten everything up. Now that everything is tightened up, there's only one thing left to do. Oh yeah. Well, that is it. We did it. We got the Burchda R5 Pro put together and she's looking fine. And the next video that I'll be doing with this bike will be a full and complete review. And when that happens, well, it's gonna end up right there. I appreciate you guys for sticking along for the ride. I hope this helped you put your bike together. And until I see you again, enjoy the ride.